Yeah, I guess with the way they want bases, they want me to run multiple teams and then position different teams at different bases, but I haven't needed multiple teams yet, except to defend these havens, and really have no reason to bring a second squad ever. The system's just feeling unfinished to me. Does it say level 7 already? This guy is the guy we just bought. Our most recent recruit's level 7 now. Wonder if he started at a higher level. So the mass training halls is giving insane amounts of experience, it looks like. It's good. Level 7, level 7. Yeah, Blade Tycon is our sniper, level 7. Level 7, level 7. Everybody on this base is level 7 now. Except the people we are out actively questing on. Or missioning on or whatever. I guess we just flesh it out. So I guess you would build like those, like right in the early game at your main base. And then you would just hire people all the time and staff your other locations to actually defend havens. I thought they would level up quickly. I wasn't thinking they'd level up like that. That's insane. Every one of our guys needs points assigned now. All right, let's get started. I want to see this priest. So they have to have this on. It's on all the time. Minus stealth plus accuracy instills frenzies. Seems good. Alright, training. Gain control of an enemy with willpower cost equal to the enemy's current willpower. So we can mind control basically nothing interesting, but whatever. What's this one? Induce panic. So we do have psionics in this game. It's kind of nice to have the full stat tree available. Biochemist. Healer, Reckless, all organic enemies within 50 tiles are automatically revealed. That seems kind of nice. Psychic Ward. It's pretty nice too. I wonder if I have to activate that or if it's a passive. Mind Crush. 100 damage to all enemy entities within 100 tiles. Huh. Do we want another class? Can we take any class? No, it's just these. Oh, we can take technician now. Why is this non-basics? Because we're allied with the people who can make technicians? So there's even more class combinations possible? I mean, this is where it starts to get a little frustrating for me, because I love the idea of this, right? What they just said is there's a really complex, a really high number of combinations of classes and class combinations you can make, which is really fun. And that it's different each game you play because you have different factions, which is super fun. But then they've said the combat's really easy and repetitive and it doesn't really matter. And that sucks. It's like, I could min-max all these builds and come up with really cool builds that did things, and it doesn't really matter because all I really need is dash on everybody. All right, those of you who finished this game, what percentage of the way through the game am I right now? 50, 70? 90? 10? I'm near the end if I rush the story missions. Let's see. Yeah, I don't know how I feel about that training ground thing. On the one hand, it's hilarious how quickly it trained our guys. On the other hand, it's ridiculous how quickly it trained our guys. So I think we would do the faction missions earlier to get the faction tech rolling. We'd build way less research labs. We'd build more manufacturers, but not by that many. We'd definitely invest in the early game training thing. The limiting factor actually seems to be minerals and production time on building the Manticore. Manticore is a 10-day build, was pretty rough. I just feel like there's a lot of unfinished systems. If I'm really actually close to the end too, like none of this has mattered then. I'm still using mostly the same weapons I started with very small upgrades. I'm using mostly the same armor I started with very small upgrades. A couple of the weapon systems got more powerful. The tank was good. We still haven't seen much in the way of enemy diversity. There's the kind of four-legged walker guys, the bugs, the mind control facehuggers, the sirens, and then those two, just like the two generic guys, the four-armed pistol dude and the two-armed grenade dude.
A renewal. Welcome back.
We did ally with Happy a faction, Santa, but we did it really late, and it's pretty uninteresting from the perspective of when we did it. If we did it earlier, maybe it could be relevant. Thank you, Hayakim, for the 5 months. Welcome back. Yeah, it's a pretty low number of alien types. Yeah, I don't know. Like, I could do this better. We could definitely min-max this better. There's 8 Phoenix bases, maybe. But why? Why do I want to up the scale of the things we're doing on the map right now? I don't really want to. It just means I have to run more of the samey fight. Even the leveling just got totally trivialized, which is kind of nuts. Like, one of the big investments in the XCOM franchises was high level characters, because they carried squads, because they had all sorts of abilities that your other guys couldn't do. But we just out leveled our A team that has been running for, like, I don't know how many days into the game we are, but we're probably 20 days into the game, right? Game time. But in about 4 days of just sitting at base, everyone else leveled. Huh. I mean, I technically haven't beat the game yet, but... And there was that one hard fight today, which was kind of fun. I mean, the enemies still behaved fairly suicidally. Although cover's different in this game, so maybe I can't call it suicidally. There are no other targets on the map. They did prioritize attacking us. How many training facilities did we make? I think it was at this one. 1, 2, 3, 4. We made 6. Bet you could get away with 4. The techs after a while just seem totally meaningless too. I hate the fact that the techs don't tell me what they do. Like, why am I investing in a tech if I have no idea what it does? I just click it because I haven't teched it yet. And then if I know what it does, like that, getting that grenade launcher earlier would have been pretty big. I did like the vehicle, but I liked the vehicle mostly because of how ridiculous it was. It was absurdly tanky. It was like getting mechs. It's very, very reminiscent of getting mechs. Yeah, it feels very unfinished, which is too bad, because some of the things I'd like to see, I'd like to see the other character classes. I'd like to start playing around with character builds across multiple classes. I would like to see what the faction weapons and faction gear is like. I'm particularly interested in the one that's the half the human hybrids, the human mutant hybrids. Storyline got worse as it went further along. Just felt like they're kind of like, oh, they're aliens as well as mutants. And they have telepathic abilities as well. Huh. I am uncertain. I don't think I want to continue this particular playthrough. I don't really care to see the end one way or the other. If I were to play again, and maybe I'll put a poll before we finish today. We'll throw up a poll and we can vote. If we play this again, if we restarted, that is, I would try to min-max super hard with the way we developed, which I think is basically the amount of resources you pull out of these exploration sites is really high. So I think it's basically grab the other bases fairly quickly, get some more manufacturing things up, and get a couple more of these jets out so you can tap multiple resources simultaneously, and then just build up a squad with training bases and staff them everywhere. But I don't know. It's just the difficulty was a little bit low in the fights. The fights were very repetitive. I don't know how many crate fights we've done in this game, but it's dozens. We've done dozens of crate fights. No dash challenge. There's not even an opportunity cost to taking dash. It costs you 10 SP. You don't even lose anything. It's the equivalent of losing not even one stat point. The SP weight of dash is less than one stat point. You have to take assault, you might say, but assault seemed pretty good overall. Shotguns were excellent. The alien damage is weird. The alien armor scaling, rather. Their health and armor scaled a lot. So maybe the new Jericho, like guns ignoring armor, would be pretty good. That's a pretty big damage increase. You know, when we're shooting 8 bursts of, of 30 damage, and now we ignore 20 armor. You know, that's 160 extra damage for a shot, which is pretty big. Mobility seemed like absolute king everywhere. Like, I almost... Like, it was nice getting the dash for extra movement, but honestly, and I think I'm gonna still do that again, of course, but I think I'd probably max mobility and willpower. I was maxing willpower and mobility, like, in that order, kind of, and I don't know if I might just put more into movement to begin with. The heavies never really seemed to get great, but they were okay. Yeah, I don't know. It just feels like this is a little bit how Erratus felt to me. There's a bunch of systems in place that aren't really properly fleshed out, but could be really cool if they were. Like, multiple bases sounds cool in theory. Having to build vehicles and extra jets and stuff sounds pretty cool in theory. A lot of class diversity sounds cool in theory. Different factions to ally with sounds cool in theory, but I don't know, maybe I'm not going far enough in the game to see these pan out. That's what I've been worried about all along. But so far, it hasn't felt like any of it matters. Do I return to it after a patch and a rebalance? Yeah. Yeah, I would. It seems, as I said, it has a bunch of systems in place that could be super cool. But it seems, it feels like the systems are superfluous right now. They don't really matter. You could probably just rush through it with the basic gear and the basic guys you had. With the exception of, like, that last mission we just, not the ambush, but the one before that, we really needed a power spike. So the vehicle was a really big power spike. Do you ever get past, do you ever outscale those vehicles? Like, if you just rush the mission line, like, why don't I just rush that fucking scarab and win? Like, if I were to just, like, straight down, like, right off the bat, first set of resources invested into manufacturers, like, 2 of those right off the bat to cut the build time on that vehicle down, and just built one. Like, what stops me? Those rockets are insane. You hit a few walls. Armor gets nuts on Pandarans. Yeah, the armor scaling was seeming pretty crazy. Two heavies with rockets output the same damage as one scarab? Maybe. Scarab is really tanky, though. The fact that I don't care if it gets hit pretty much at all is really interesting. It has a lot of max HP. Like, 500 max HP is quite a bit. It means I don't get alpha'd in a turn, even if a couple enemies are shooting me, which I can't say of any of my units. The scarab was actually fairly mobile, too, in a way that heavies weren't. But I mean, think of it, right? Like, what the training stuff tells us, the way the training facilities work, is that investing in your early game troops for getting them experience is not actually something that's meaningful. So I almost think the opposite, right? Like, what I should actually do is rush the tank, use the tank to carry in the early game, the early to mid game. Then, as I'm doing that, invest in training facilities. Then go on a, like, recruiting spree where I pick up as many, like, rookies of interest in classes as I can, dump them in the place that levels up, use the tank to get me into, I guess that would be early mid game by then, and then roll out of that with, like, 10 level 7s of all the classes I want. And then maybe I do put the tank back away and pull out the level 7s because they're better, but I've skipped all the hard part of leveling low levels. There's no reason to. I mean, the tank starts as good as it will ever get. Everybody else has to be brought up to that. Only drawback to this if you want to squash early nests and layers. I didn't find early nests and layers a hard mission though. I didn't find any of the missions hard. I mean, I certainly didn't like the kill or be killed kind of every time you aggro is kill or be killed, because if you stand around, your guys are instantly dead and cover doesn't really work in the system and enemies come from all directions. But I didn't really feel like the missions were hard. I just felt like they were very front loaded in terms of how you need to do things. As I said, the hardest mission we played was two missions ago, and that was a fairly fun mission because it was more challenging. I had to think about it. I had to make decisions. And even then it felt a little, at some point I'm just like, I'm capturing all the things I'm interested in. All right. Well, I'll throw it up to vote chat and we can decide for tomorrow. I don't quite know what my alternative plan is right now, so I might do it anyways, but I'm kind of curious what you guys think about it. I don't know that this really, at the moment, warrants another playthrough. I would say it doesn't. Like, it was fun, but it's like you're on the ground floor, you know, you're climbing a mountain, right? And you're at the bottom. I'm going to do an Arvia-style analogy, which is like all sorts of weird things in there for no reason. But you're at the bottom of a mountain climbing up, and you're like seeing all these kind of like cool things like rising around you, like leveling, and you've got like vehicles, and you've got multiple bases, and you have, you know, multiple faction armors. And as you just keep climbing, you get above it, and you look down, and they're all a little like, you know, two-dimensional kind of like, you know, just like the fronts of buildings and this type of shit as you climb past it, and you realize none of it has any depth or meaning whatsoever. That's how I feel like we felt at the end of this. Which is too bad, because I think the game has a lot of potential. But even that's bad game design, crazy for Swift, right? Which is if the game difficulty is all over the place, you never have a sense of how strong your guys are relative to what you're supposed to be doing. Every crate mission was insanely easy, because the enemies just shoot crates, and then you just kill them. And if I suddenly get a weird power spike out of nowhere from the enemies, it doesn't make sense why. They haven't accomplished things. They aren't doing what they're trying to do. I mean, I guess maybe 20% progress is, but for the very large portion of the game, we are at 2% enemy progress. Why are they getting random spikes of power from what? And if it's just coded in because this mission has these enemies on it, well, once you played it, that's what you're working with. That's your limiting factors. When can you beat that? Not if that makes sense or not. Yeah. Anyways, kind of fun. A lot of new systems. Check it out. I'm glad we checked it out. I don't regret that at all. I would play it again after some patching from the game devs themselves and the studio, and then hopefully some modding from the community, because it needs a lot of those bugs ironed out, and it needs a actual game difficulty. It just feels unfinished. It feels like it's about 6 months unfinished. Yeah, Xanabu does. And I've been holding off giving this summary because what I've been trying to do is get to a point where I can look back and see did any of these things. Because some of the stuff is fun. Like the leveling systems, this is fun. This is a fun little system they have for leveling. There's, you know, different, there's like, you know, what is there? Five different classes. There's more than that. There's three classes from each. There's two classes from each faction, right? They have a specialty class and like an elite class. So that's six. And then you start with your base three, that's a nine. And then you can combine any two of those, apparently. I don't know if it was the combination. No, it's the non-elite. So you can combine six of those nine, you can combine. And then the elite ones, I guess you can combine with the other six options or other, yeah, something like that. So I don't know quite the way that works out. I have to put a pen and paper to figure out what that works out to class combinations, but there's a lot of class combinations available. And then the unique random specialty kind of bonuses they do suggest specializations, which is cool. That means your characters are going to be different from run to run, and they're going to be different from faction to faction, and they're going to be there's going to be some choices about building them, and that's super cool. Like, that's a cool system. It's a cool system to have multiple bases, jets, and vehicles. So that's a cool system. I don't even hate the scanning system. It's a little repetitive, but the fights are garbage, man. And in a strategy based around squad-based tactical combat, you need your fights to be good. And they aren't. They aren't good right now at all. And it's not like it was a payoff for it in the late game. And it's not like the storyline's great either. And if some of you are watching this later, like if this makes it up to YouTube, and I think it will, I'll talk to the editor about making sure the summary gets in there. And you guys think I'm not giving it its fair due, Like there's some really good late game content that we haven't got to that starts really getting hard and really interesting and it's worth sticking around for. Post about why that is, because at the moment I don't see it. So, all right, guys, I'm out of here. Thanks for watching. The most friend on the way out. Just gonna smack the mic. My apologies.